video on my snake diet journey, and I'm gonna be talking about how I've already failed and that how I've almost wanted to give up about 1,000 times. So of course, if you're new to my channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button down here as well as the little bell so you are notified when I upload videos every single week. So like I mentioned, I already failed on this journey. So I actually went 93 hours in my very first fast before my refeed, and I actually ate this right here, and this actually consumed about less than 1,700 calories. So pretty impressive that I literally got all these calories in literally less than half an hour. Needless to say, I was extremely full, but felt amazing because it was delicious. After my refeed is when I really struggled. And I actually, before doing this process, I actually did a test run of like an 83-hour fast. And I literally experienced the exact same thing on my refeed. And that's kind of when I quit and said, maybe this isn't for me, but something kept drawing me back to it. So needless to say, after my refeed, the very next day, I was literally completely ravenous with these binge thoughts, wanting to give up. And literally, like, these thoughts were probably 100 times greater in just the intensity than like a usual binge. I definitely felt like these thoughts completely overpowered me, and I gave in to like some chocolate chips that were at work and some chips. So these items, or really anything that is bad, is not at my house at all. I do not have anything bad at my house. And literally right now, everything is pretty much in my freezer. Definitely work is a trigger for me amongst other places that I also experienced as more part of this journey. So after that happened, I messaged Cole and I was like, here's what happened. Do you have any sort of thoughts or maybe something I can do to help kind of curb these intense binging feelings that I have? And basically he just said, vlog about it. Tell people how I effed up. So here I am telling you guys all how I completely messed up. And not only did I completely mess up there, but the very next day, which is my day off, I actually was watching my little nephew, and going over to my sister's house is also a big trigger for me because she has 2 children. So in the house, it is a bunch of stuff that's already open. Naturally, I was like, this day I felt like was gonna be a complete mess in the first place. So I definitely like had a complete binge worthy of food. Before I mention, of course, what I weighed this morning, I should probably tell you what I weighed when I started the snake diet fast. So day one, I actually topped at my heaviest weight to date. Needless to say, I got in some extra snacks the night before, but I weighed at 204 pounds and 8 ounces. Yikes. That kind of hurts a little bit, like hurts real bad. So after all of this, oh, before my refeed that morning, I was 193.6, so that is good. I did not have a scale before I did my refeed, but I can only assume it was probably a pound less or so than that 193. But anyway, so today I weighed in at 197 pounds on the dot. Which means even though I failed like twice, I still am 7.8 pounds down. So yay! Also, several times today, I really wanted to give up and I just wanted to say, you know, maybe I should just eat today because like Tuesday is usually my refeed day, like why not? But I told myself, stop, Carly, I'm already fasting. So what I'm gonna do is, like I mentioned, how I was gonna do like a Tuesday and Saturday, I'm just going to listen to myself. So if I wanna eat like Thursday night, it's completely fine. So what Cole ultimately had recommended, if you do not wanna do like the 2 days a week, he had mentioned as like the eat big and fast long, but basically you're going to eat until you lose 2 pounds and then you refeed, and then you continuously fast until you lose 2 pounds again. So that may be a method that maybe I'll try if I can't keep my binging thoughts at bay. So some things that have definitely kept me on this journey, even though I've literally wanted to give up several times a day, every day on this journey, is that especially with this extreme binging thoughts that I have, I've really realized that I'm not gonna cure my lifetime of binging thoughts and addiction thoughts in one 96-hour fast. Like, it's gonna take some time. So I'm just trying to be like completely patient with myself. And the one thing about this lifestyle is that it's all about discipline. So clearly I lack some discipline in my life, and so that's something that I'm going to be working on. And I know deep down that the fasts are gonna get easier, like the more that I do them and the more that I combat these thoughts. And as Cole always says, enjoy being uncomfortable. Because when you're uncomfortable, there is literally a pot of gold waiting for you on the other side of it. And then something else I want to address, because some of you who are following me are not a fan of Cole Robinson, and that is completely okay. And what I can tell you, it's not really about him like being verbally abusive to you. If you can think of it as he's being verbally abusive to your fat cells, because when he's talking, I'm not like, man, he's talking to me personally. He's not. He's just basically trying to get a point across and like strike a chord within yourself for change. Because one of the first things I remember from when I first watched him, where I was like, who in the beep is that guy? I'm like, I'm gonna read all these comments. I'm gonna read how everyone hates him. So I started scrolling through all these comments and I was like, wait a minute, there isn't like one negative comment on here, and there are hundreds and hundreds of comments. And that's when it dawned on me, like, you know, Carly, stop taking everything personal. He's not talking to me. And with that, taking things not personal, if I can make any recommendations for anyone reading an amazingly short book, it is The Four Agreements right here. I have it on audiobook. It is a really fast audiobook or a quick read. I highly recommend it because the number one rule that I took from it personally is take nothing personal, because it isn't about you. As hard and as much as we wanted to make it about ourselves. Now I'm ready to embark on another week, and I appreciate each and every single one of you like supporting me. And the Snake Diet Motivation Group on Facebook is truly amazing. Everyone supports everyone so extremely much. Like, I honestly love it. So when I have these crazy thoughts, I thought of all sorts of things that I can do. And one of them is to go onto the Facebook page right here and just like absorb myself in these positive thoughts from other people. Also, I've saved a little folder on my phone photos that is just for the snake diet juice, where I can just go through like some screenshots of some before and afters that I really like and that kind of motivate me. I am pumped for next week because that is when I will take more photos and actually show my before photos. And you can see where I've landed. So fingers crossed I keep it together this week. And if not, I'm just going with the flow and keep going. Do not stop. So of course, thank you all for watching and for the support and for the love. I appreciate each and every single one of you. And of course, we will see you soon.